our families, our communities, our relationships can become heavenly if we too follow her secret of adding love to everything we do and speak. My dear brothers and sisters, in a world where greatness is measured by what one has, Jesus gives a new norm of greatness based on who one is. The world understands and promotes greatness based on what one has. If one is wealthy, or one has a good name, or one belongs to a known family, or one has talents and abilities that are considered special, or one is intelligent, and so on, and then that person is noble in the society. People look up to him or her as someone great. His or her words are respected, suggestions they make are taken seriously, and they are obeyed as well, without any hesitation. But Jesus' view of greatness is not based on what one has. I might have wealth, good number of friends around me, great family that I belong to, or big qualifications that I have, so on and so forth, but I need not be great in the eyes of Jesus. For Jesus, greatness is based on who one is. And in the gospel today, Jesus says that whoever humbles himself like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Those who become like little children can only enter into the kingdom of God, he says. But what does it mean to become like a little child? It is to become like Jesus himself. Saint Jerome says, truly he set himself in the midst of them, a little one who had come not to be ministered unto, but to minister, that he might be a pattern of holiness. This is what the life of Saint Teresa of Child Jesus teaches, whose feast we celebrate today. As a result of her rigorous search for the way to become a saint, she found her path, her vocation. She says, O Jesus, my love, my vocation, at last I have found it. My vocation is love. She lived this vocation of love with utmost perfection. She didn't do mighty deeds, rather her little ways of loving Jesus and small ways of daily sacrifices made her a saint. Her little secrets of humiliation and good deeds amounted to a great wealth for her in heaven. Adding love in everything we do is the secret she found in her life to transform her world into a little heaven. To add love is to add Christ into everything and gradually become another Christ. Our families, our communities, our relationships can become heavenly if we too follow her secret of adding love to everything we do and speak. Amen.